Hi, welcome to Econometrics with Coach G. If this is your first course with us, then welcome. If this is, one of the second or whatever courses that you're taking with us, welcome back. In this course, you're essentially expected to take a follow-up course for, Statistics 1 and Statistics 2, or Statistics however you've done it, whether it's in one part or two parts. So I would like to, kind of begin by trying to explain the syllabus structure. I will also be going over how, we cover the kind of questions that there are. What are the kind of expectations that you should have out of these videos, and, what are the expectations that you should have from yourself as a student? Basically just talk about how we plan to go forward. Okay, so there are essentially 6 units in econometrics. Okay, so there are 6 units. The first unit is obviously the most basic one. It's the nature and scope of econometrics. This we will be covering in the next 2 videos itself. So here I'm going to talk about, why econometrics is different from statistics. What is it that is expected, which is out of the subject, which is starkly in contrast with statistics as a discipline. Why do we need a separate subject to begin with, and so on and so forth. The second unit, so this unit, while it may not, you may not think that it's very important, I think it's important in the sense that it helps you helps keep you grounded into why you are doing this to begin with. Because trust me when I say this, econometrics can be a little frustrating. There is a lot of new concepts to grasp. There is a lot of mathematical I don't know what the right word for it is. I would use the word mathematical I'm struggling to find a word here, but the point is that there is a lot of math involved. There is proving and equations and a lot of things that a lot of people don't like. But if you keep into mind what is it that you started from, and if you keep into mind why is it that you're doing this, even understanding those concepts becomes a little easier, because you have a broader context of what exactly is happening. Because if you don't have a broader context, then trust me, when I studied econometrics for the first time, I didn't have a broader context, and I was just like, why are we doing this? So I hope to be able to kind of guide you to a place where you don't ask that question at the very least. Even if you don't like it, you at least should be able to understand why it is it that you're expected to know it. So that is one. So naturally, because like I said, it's a follow-up course to econometrics, the second unit is actually statistical inference. Now this is more or less it's more or less taken completely from the previous statistics that you have learned. You are going to be talking about the T and the F distribution. You're going to be talking about test statistics. All of these are things that you've covered in your statistics course at some point. Now obviously, if you don't remember, or if you need a recap, I will be giving you a recap. The videos for this unit are they should be treated as a recap to what you've already done, because it is what you have already done. In case obviously you require more assistance, you should talk to us. So in this statistical inference unit, it is to kind of statistics, it's like saying that econometrics kind of begins where statistics ends. So statistical inference is just sort of statistical inference would kind of answer the questions of what and how for any data set, and then econometrics gets to the why part of it. Okay, so in this unit we're going to be covering concepts which you would need to further use in the rest of the course for econometrics. Now the third unit and the fourth unit, these are going to be the major chunks of your syllabus. The third unit is the simple linear regression model, The second, fourth one is going to be multiple linear regression model, right? Now, both of them are extremely important, okay? And neither can be skipped, whatever. I mean, you know, both of them kind of lead up to each, I mean, lead from each other. So the multiple linear regression model is naturally just a extension of the simple linear regression model. Just to kind of, you know, make it clear off the bat, it's not like we're going to be expecting you to, you know, see multiple equations here. The equation still remains one, but the way you see it kind of starts becoming different. So, you know, it's not too scary. I hope I haven't scared you. It's just that, you know, it's, I mean, it's this is an extension of this, and honestly, in the real world, you only ever use this. So, in these two units, you're going to be building up on the fundamental concepts which make up econometrics. We're going to be covering a lot of topics, you know, which are standard for studying regression models everywhere. And yeah, so for these units, by the way, I would like to tell you that my intention would be to cover the theory part of the units first, which is to say, what is it that, you know, is in the theory, talk about the main, you know, major sort of theorems, etc., which are, you know, a part of them, and then towards the end, start of, you know, start off with the questions. So for some, I mean, I would say probably 4 to 5 videos, you may feel that, you know, you're doing a lot of theory and no kind of, no application of it, but believe me when I say this, you need that theory, without which you will never understand the application. So the way that these two units in particular are going to be structured is that I would like to cover a lot of theory first, so that, you know, we have a ground that we have built, and then post that we will be doing questions according to the things that, you know, come in your exams. By the way, in my understanding and what from whatever I've seen so far, the econometrics papers are never too difficult, okay? It's just that because, and that's partly because of the fact that, you know, the concept is entirely new to you, so they wouldn't want you to feel overwhelmed. But that also means that, you know, the theory and the simple things that are there in your syllabus hold a lot of importance, because it's very important that you know what you have in the syllabus, because that those are the things that they can test you on, right? So, you know, that's just, you know, a small comment. The fifth unit is also, by the way, the third and the fourth unit are mostly going to be covered in a sense together. Like, if you ask me, you know, how do I differentiate between videos for the third unit and videos for the fourth unit, I will not be able to do it particularly, mostly because of the fact that both of these units, like I said, are too connected. So there will be times where I will be covering some topic of, you know, unit 4 and unit 3 and so on and so forth. So also because, you know, understand that it's your book which has separated them into, you know, two units. Otherwise, as concepts, they are, you know, not that separable. Okay. The fifth unit talks about violations of the classical assumptions. Now, you know, in the past, I have seen that by the time we get here, you know, you are already so exhausted with the rest of, you know, the things that have happened, that you would like to kind of feel that, I mean, I don't know, again, I don't know how to say this, but, you know, you kind of feel like, oh, okay, you know, ye toh hume aata hai, because it's just a violation of an assumption that we have read. I would, you know, strongly suggest not taking this unit that lightly. Number one, because if they wanted to make the paper difficult, the things that they would test you on would come from this unit, right? Because this is basic theory. This they can't really, I mean, you can't really change the basic theory of a subject. This, however, can be, you know, twisted in ways where you may be expected to recognize the violations instead of just, you know, being asked about, oh, can you describe this particular violation for me. So there are three violations here. There is multicollinearity, there is heteroscedasticity, and there's serial correlation. Again, all three may sound completely foreign to you, and that's okay. You're not expected to know this at all. I mean, of course, by the end of the course, you're expected to know this. Right now, it's okay. So yeah. And the last unit is actually something called specification analysis. Now, in my, again, understanding, this particular unit can be combined with this unit, mostly because specification analysis is also a kind of So, I mean, both of these units essentially talk about limitations to the modeling exercise. So this one will talk about limitations in the sense that, you know, some assumption that you've made is not satisfied. This is talking about limitation in the sense that, you know, your model is wrongly specified. That's where the specification comes from. So both of these units are, in a sense, addressing the issue of the fact that your model has some limitations. That's exactly how I'm again possibly going to be covering it. However, here the videos won't be that, you know, intertwined, because even though they come fall under the same bracket of limitations, they do not they're not exactly the same thing, right? So that's about it. So these are the six units. I will, you know, reiterate that it's a heavy course. It's going to be a heavy course. So the two suggestions that I have is, number one, be regular in watching the videos. Number two, when you're following on any proof or anything that I do in a video, particularly for the theory units, which is units 3 and 4, please go back and do the theorem or the proof or whatever it is that, you know, we have done yourself. Because and I cannot, you know, reiterate this enough. You may think that you know it because, you know, you've seen it, and because it seems deceptively simple. Econometrics is like that. It seems deceptively, you know, you're like, oh, of course it makes sense, you know. But when it actually comes to doing it yourself, you get confused in even the most simple of things. And that's okay. Like, you know, everybody goes through that phase. Everybody goes to the point where, you know, they don't get econometrics that much. But the point is to kind of, you know, move over that phase within the span of the semester itself, because you will be tested on it at some point, right? So that is something that I will, you know, strongly suggest that you do. Please follow up on the units as we go. Do not think that, you know, because it's just one equation, you know, you can whatever pick it up at the end and have your merry way with it. It's not that simple. And also so, you know, I think I've made that point enough. The second point that I would like to make is that everything in econometrics particularly, more than statistics. So in statistics, you know, topics can be things like, okay, you know, I have this, and, you know, I have X and I have Y, and, you know, even though Y comes after X, X and Y can be studied separately. In econometrics, that's not the case. Everything that you do is kind of connected. So it's like a, you know, it's like a story, so to say. Although maybe a story is a wrong analogy. It's not, you know, it's not it's a mathematical story, if you will. So the point is that, you know, you cannot just pick up a unit in the middle and expect that you will understand the videos, or you know, even the things that we are doing, or even, you know, from yourself. So that expectation is wrong from yourself, and it's also wrong from, you know, our end. Because please understand that it's not that I'm making each unit, you know, as a video that should make sense to anybody and everybody. No. I am making that unit as a follow-up of the previous unit, which means that I will be, you know, expecting you to know things that I have discussed previously, and those are not things that you can simply, you know, get away with. So, you know, long story short, the point is that because everything is connected, it is important that you keep up. It is also important that you consistently follow up. And it's also important that you don't think that you can pick up something from the middle and, you know, simply understand it. Of course, if you've been following the same course, you know, in your colleges, it may so happen that, you know, you would be able to follow. And if that happens, I'm, you know, gladder than, you know, you are. But that being said, you cannot, I mean, don't judge videos in isolation, or even not just videos. I mean, videos at what? But the point is, don't try to do this subject in isolation, because you will not succeed, and it will be very frustrating. So, yeah, I think I've made all the points that I wanted to. So yeah, that's it for this video. In the next video, we're going to be starting with the first unit. Thank you.